Previously, when we talked about FGO's new FN skills, grails, and coins, lots of you had questions. So today, we'll be answering your questions and calculating how many coins you need. For those new to the channel, welcome to Bad Anime Decisions, where we waste money on anime merch so you don't have to. For the first FN skills extra attack, is it only for the extra cards? Yes, this is for the fourth extra card that shows up in the Brave Chain, and isn't an extra damage boost to everything. What do supports like Tamamo or Miyu get for the third FN skills? Attack would be kinda useless for them. Yes, attack is rather useless for them, but the third skills are still attack up towards a specific class. Unless they're a berserker like Nightingale, since berserkers get increased critical damage resistance towards a specific class instead. Which is even more useless in my opinion. Is there a way to sort servants by how many coins they have? Not that I know of, but in the FN skill upgrade menu, you can go to the sorting options, turn on smart sort, and it only place servants that are capable of being upgraded at the top of the list. This includes both servants that have enough coins to unlock a skill, and servants that already have skills unlocked but can upgrade the skill level with QP and materials. Sorting by bond levels or NP levels isn't very helpful since that doesn't take into account the rarity of the servant. If I only want my SSR to get the second FN skill, then I only need to raise them to level 6 bond. Correct, one copy of an SSR nets you 90 coins, and at 5 coins per bond from 1 to 6, having an SSR at NP 1 and bond 6 will give you a total of 120 coins, exactly enough to unlock one FN skill. You can unlock any FN skill you want too, so you can go straight to the second skill and skip over the first one. Is the stat increase for level 100 to 120 the same as from 90 to 100? If so, it may be worth doing it for one servant for the 2k more attack and HP. Yes, you get about 100 points each in attack and HP per level, so increasing from 100 to 120 will get you 2k in each. In my opinion, using coins to unlock the first and second FN skills first seems to be a better use, and then there's a high grail cost required too, but it's up to how much you have and what playstyle you use. Since welfares are limited SRs, do you get 250 coins for NP5? Enough for 2 skills? Actually, no. This is pretty disappointing, but since welfares come from events instead of from the gacha, you don't get any coins for a copy of a servant. The only coins for welfares you can get right now are from bond. I speculate that you can probably get more coins from them from future event reruns, or just new events that are thematically similar. There's no confirmation on that though, so take it with a grain of salt, but at the same time, don't get too sad either. The feature is still new. Solo units like Herc might get more mileage out of the extra card buff. Yeah, that could be the case. Even in non-solo comps, for long fights, a DPS servant like Kama can use the NP multiple times and get lots of charge from supports, so the extra card could be better than a one-time 20% NP charge at start of the battle. For farming, that 20% NP charge can give you a pseudo super scope, which is amazing. I have normal kaleidoscopes on my Raikou and Ibaraki with their second FN skills maxed, and they can just come out and bust an NP right away. It's great. Do the skills carry over from a friend's list unit too? Yes! As a matter of fact, if you hit the third blue button next to the class selector, you can toggle whether to show the normal skill levels or append skill levels. On my list, barely anyone has their append skills unlocked though, and even when they do, it's not always maxed. So it might take a time for the pseudo super scopes to be common on the support list. Is it possible to get someone up to 120 off of bond alone? Even if you're not unlocking any append skills, it still won't be enough if you only have one copy. It takes 300 coins to grail to 120. Even if the servants and SSR, that's 90 coins for one copy from the gacha, and getting them to bond 10 will net you another 80, being 170 total. Going to bond 15 will give another 100, getting you to 270. How many coins do you get for bond 10? 80 total. How many coins do you get for bond 15? 180 total. How many coins do you get for NP5 non-limited 4-star? 5 times 30, so 150. Enough for one FN skill before bond coins. What if I want them to get 2 FN skills? Get them to bond 11, or wait for future events? How many coins do you get for an NP5 limited 4-star? 5 times 50, so 250. Enough for 2 FN skills before the bond coins. How do we get 1 FN skill for an NP1 4-star? Bond 10 if they're limited, bond 11 if not limited. But what about, we need to give you a mass class, take the coins you get per servant, multiplied by the amount of copies you already have. Add by 5 times how many bond levels you have in the 1 to 6 range, then add by 10 times how many bonds you have in the 7 to 9 range, and then add by 20 times how many bond levels you have in the 10 to 15 range. That's how many coins you should get for that servant. Do you need to use crystallized lores to max out an append skill? Yes, but since you don't have to worry about skill cooldowns, I don't recommend maxing them out except for the NP1 for a solid 20% charge. So even if you max bond them at NP5, it's still not enough to hit level 120 while also unlocking all the append skills. At the moment, yes, you need 660 to absolutely max everything out. Even for an SSR, NP5 will net you 450 coins, and bond 10 will get you another 80, giving 530. If you use a weird bond grail thing to go up to bond 15, that will give you another 100, putting you at 630. But let's wait and see if they give us more coins in other ways before we get angry. This is disgusting. Even if you are a whale, you will struggle to get the coins to level 120 and get all FN skills. Well, yes, but I wouldn't call this disgusting at all. Getting to max out everything isn't going to impact gameplay that much, and it's a long-term goal for a servant that you really love, or if you just really feel like flexing on others. You're not supposed to be able to do it right away when they just implemented the feature. It's something to aspire to for the long term. The NP charge FN skill alone is already a huge quality of life upgrade for farming. I don't see any reason to be mad. This update is great and exciting. Anyone else feel like this is a big FU to F2P? Every time there's a new feature released, there are posts saying it's a way to screw over F2P players. But no one needs to have any character at best 120. F2P players already hugely benefit from being able to pseudo super scope without getting a bunch of kaleidoscope copies. People need to stop having the entitled mindset that you need to be able to get everything in the game right away. Anyways, I hope that answered your questions. If you found this helpful, maybe throw me a like. My question to you is, which servers have you been upgrading? Are you having more fun with them? Please subscribe for more bad anime decisions, and maybe check out our review of this figure of Clankfest Idol Miyu. I'll see you again, and as always, Gacha was a mistake.